Welcome back, Tigers. In this video, we will learn how to create campaign influence records for a last touch campaign attribution model. If you haven't watched our three other videos on campaign influence, we highly recommend you watch those first. Links to those videos can be found down below. They cover the basics and give you a solid foundation of how campaign influence works. Let's hop over to Salesforce and see how to create a flow for our last touch attribution model. Here we are in Salesforce, and we are going to create a last touch campaign attribution model and update all of our flows to create campaign influence records for this model. If you haven't completed the steps in our previous campaign influence videos, make sure you go complete those. You're going to be a little lost in this one because everything that we're doing is bolting on top of the flows that we built for the first touch campaign attribution model. Our first step we're gonna do is go into our model settings, and we're gonna make the last touch our default model. The reason why we're doing that is because it's gonna make testing a lot easier. We're gonna be able to see the last touch campaign influence records get created right from the opportunity. Our next step is to go to our flows, and we're going to update all of them to work for our last touch model. And we're going to go to our opportunity contact role, created campaign influence automation flow that we created in the last one. We'll open this up. And we're gonna come down to our decision element where it looks for which kind of model we're working with. And we're going to add our last touch model here. And we want it to look for the developer name of the current campaign influence model that the loop is looping through. So we'll just copy that resource right there, and we'll say equals, and we'll do last underscore touch. Our next step is to add a sort. And this is gonna sort our campaign member collection. And we're gonna sort it descending because we want the most recent campaign to be on top. So we're going to get this collection here, our campaign member collection, and we're going to sort it by the created date, and we're going to make it descending. And then we're going to connect this element to our loop, and then we've got one more step. We need to do an assignment for our counter. So we need to assign a value of 1 to our counter. And the reason why we have to do this is because it's looping through first our first touch model, and it's looking for one record, and then it's going to go to our last touch model. And we only want it to find one record there as well. So we need to zero out our counter after it routes through our first touch. Here, there. All right, we'll do a save as, save, and that's it. That's all we needed to do on this one. The next flow we're going to work on is our campaign member flow. We're going to go to the flow called campaign member, campaign influence record automation. We created this in our first touch video as well. I'm going to scroll down here, and we're going to go to this decision element, and we're going to add another outcome for last touch. And then we're going to look for this developer name, the loop. It's looping through our custom campaign influence models, and we're going to look for that name to be last underscore touch. Our next step is to add a collection filter here. We're gonna filter our campaign member, campaign influence rather, collection here. And we wanna find only the ones that have a model name of last touch. Then we're gonna do an assignment. And we're gonna assign the record count of our collection filter. So we're going to create a new variable here called called var record count. This is going to be a number, no decimals, default value of 0. And then we're going to make it equal the count of our collection filter. And you want to make sure that you select the last touch collection filter here. Then we're going to do a decision, and we're going to check to make sure that our collection filter has records in it. So we're going to look for the last touch campaign influence record to exist. And then we're going to check to see if this record count is greater than or equal to 1. We'll just rename our default outcome here. So if we do have a last touch campaign influence record, we're going to add a sort here. And we're going to do a sort on our opportunity contact roles. So we did a get earlier in this flow to query our opportunity contact roles. And now we want to filter for the one that has the most recent created date. Actually, the oldest created date, sorry. So opportunity created date is descending. I always get those backwards. I don't know if you do too. We're going to set the maximum number of items to 1. So here we're going to do a collection sort, and then we're going to point this over to the loop. Now, the reason why we're doing this is we're just limiting the number of records that are going to come over to this loop. We don't have to, but we want to. Oh, and it looks like the sort order didn't stick. There we go. So this makes it so that this collection only has one record in it. So we're only pushing one record over to the loop so that this flow is more efficient and it doesn't have to work so hard. All right, then we're gonna come down here. And right before we create the campaign influence records, we're going to do a decision element here. And here we're going to check to see if the last campaign influence record exists again. So we're going to check that record count, and we're going to see if it's greater than or equal to 1. And if there are records in there, we want to delete them because we only want there to be one campaign influence record for the last touch model per contact. So we're going to delete the records that are in the last touch collection filter. So you want to select this one right here. We're going to do a save as, we'll save, and then we'll activate. All right, our next flow is our opportunity contact role deleted master flow. I'm going to go to this one right here. And we're going to add a decision here. And we're going to copy what we're doing here. So we're just getting the model developer name from the loop. In the campaign influence record right here, and we're looking for that to be last underscore touch. Then we can just copy this and paste this over here, and we'll modify the names. And then we'll make this say last touch. All right, and then if the collection does not contain last touch, we're just gonna route this over to here because it's gonna do the same actions. Then I'm gonna save this and activate it. All right, the next flow. We're going to go to our campaign influence percentage automation flow. All right, this one, you guessed it. We're just going to copy everything from our first touch and make another outcome for last touch. All right, we're going to look for this text variable to be last touch. Okay, and the next thing that we're doing is we're filtering our collection up here. So we can copy this. Give that a good name, filter for model name equal to last touch, and then we'll just change this. So this is going to filter for our campaign influence records that have a model name of last touch. Now we need to check to see if there are any records. So we're going to assign the count here so we can copy that as well. And then we can leave that. Oh no, we can't. So we are counting the number of records that are in this filter collection for last touch, and we're assigning it to this variable right here, var campaign influence record count. Now we're going to loop, so we can copy this loop. So we're going to loop our filtered campaign influence collection. And this should be called last touch. There we go. And then we're going to do the same thing that we did here. We're going to do an assignment so we can copy this one as well. All right, so we're assigning the ID for our campaign influence record that we are looking to update the influence percentage for. And we need to update this to be the ID of the filtered collection for last touch. So let's take this out. Should be that right there. And then it should be the campaign influence ID. So the current item, let's just make sure backspace over this. So the current item in the loop for the filtered campaign influence last touch collection, the ID, that's what we want to assign there. So that is correct. And then these two stay the same. All right, we'll do a save as, and we will activate this. And that is it. That's all the flows that we needed to update. So now we're ready to test. So let's come over to our opportunity. And our opportunity doesn't have any contact roles, so we're really starting from scratch here. So we're going to add Danny. All right, so we've got our last touch campaign attribution model is default. So we expect to see the model name is last touch. That is correct. Our influence is being assigned as 100%. And we've got this campaign right here. It's InsureCon, and the first associated date was today. So let's check Danny's campaign history and just make sure that that's the most recent campaign, but it sounds like it is. And it is, that is perfect. Let's go ahead and add another contact role. Let's add Bryn. Let's click save there. And then we should see a last touch for Bryn as well, which we do. And the first associated date was 11/20/2023. So the created date for this campaign or this opportunity is 1/10. So we have 180 days that we can go back prior to this op created date. So this sounds correct. It's within that date. Let's go check out Bryn's record and just make sure that that's the most recent campaign that Bryn has been associated with. And yep, it looks like there's only one here. All right, now let's test our campaign member flow. So If we add Bryn to a campaign, this should be the most recent campaign that Bryn is associated with, and therefore would then come over here and update and add a campaign influence record to this opportunity. And then we should see this particular campaign influence record get deleted. Okay, so remember this is cover care. Let's go ahead and add Bryn to a different campaign. We'll do secure guard. And now remember, we have to do a status of responded here. So however you have your statuses set up, whichever one has the responded checkbox equal to true, make sure you select that one. So now let's pop over to our campaign influence and see if this got updated, and it did. Perfect. So our last record that was the last touch got deleted, and our new record for campaign influence got added. Our influence percentages are 50%. So this all looks like it's working great. Let's go ahead and do a couple of more tests. Let's go ahead and delete Bryn. And we want to make sure that that campaign influence record corresponding to Bryn is also deleted, which it was. Now I'm going to add Bryn back, and we're going to go check out some reports because something exciting should be happening. We should be seeing campaign influence records in our reporting for both first touch and last touch now. So let's go check out what that would look like. I'm going to go into reports, and I've got a campaign influence report here. This report is just the standard campaign influence report type. It's campaigns with influenced opportunities, has customizable campaign influence in parentheses. Now you can see here that I am getting first touch campaign influence records in this report for both Bryn and Danny on different opportunities. And I do have last touch. So this opportunity that I was just working with, we can see that we are getting records created for both Bryn and Danny, and for on the first touch model as well as the last touch model. Now we can also see the revenue share was updated correctly on both the first touch and the last touch. So we have two campaign attribution models working, running perfectly, our first touch and our last touch. All right,
that's it, that's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on the next video we are working on that will show you how to create a flow that creates campaign influence records for an even distribution custom model. This type of model will give each campaign equal revenue share of the opportunity's amount. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you'd like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.